In this lesson, you will learn how to use vray's built-in denoiser feature to get noise-free images and save over 85% render time. Hi, my name is Benjamin with BWMC. In this class, we use Maxon's Cinema 4D and ChaosGroup's vray for Cinema 4D. Saving time is always important. That's why I want to show you how you can meet tight deadlines a lot easier. But first, I want to compare with you two rendered frames coming directly from Cinema 4D using vray. This image on my right side used vray's built-in denoiser. It looks fairly clean. This image didn't use the denoiser and rendered with a noise threshold of 0.005. This is a very common value for production quality renders. Now let's compare the render times. The unprocessed image with a noise threshold of 0.005 rendered 32 minutes and 8 seconds to finish the frame. The denoised image used a noise threshold of 0.075 and otherwise unaltered render settings. This image rendered in 4 minutes and 2 seconds. Now, that is a time saving of 87.5%. For this 75 frames animation, it means saving approximately 35 hours. By the way, I am using a moderately powered computer with a Cinebench R20 score of 2860 points. Modern CPUs will accomplish much faster results. Now let's compare the quality of the two images to determine which render setting is high enough for the denoiser to perform well. Let me zoom in for you to 200%. The denoiser uses several passes to compute the denoised image, probably most importantly a normal map of the image. The result is a detailed preserving image that is highly denoised. The denoised image used a noise threshold of 0.075 and otherwise unaltered render settings. Once vray's denoiser has processed the image, it will look like this. Now pay attention, I'm zoomed in 400%, but you can see the grainy image turned into a clean image. Let me zoom out to 100%. At 100%, you can also see a big difference between the grainy image and the cleaned up image. But here in the reflection, you can see the hard shadow is washed out. Be aware that the image will get a little blurry in comparison. It depends on your needs and if you can live with that, or if you will have to raise your render settings a little more. In my case, it isn't that important to have the shadow being hard, so I'm fine with it and happy to save 28 minutes for this one single frame. Let me show you how to set it up. Go to your Cinema 4D render settings and make sure you have vray bridge selected as your render engine. In the options tab, hit the show VFB option to activate it. Make sure multipass with added post effects is set up. You won't need the save checkmark activated. We will use vray's save function. In your antialiasing tab, use a noise threshold of 0.1 or any other low quality value. I use 0.075. Production quality is at around 0.005. In the translator tab, make sure the option render and save VFB are both activated. For the VFB image file, choose a folder and file name. For the format, I use 32-bit EXR. If you want to save space on your hard drive, you can also choose another format. But I like to have full control over the image when I color correct it later. Pay attention to the file format and file extension. Vray won't update your file name with the right file extension. You'll have to change it manually. Now let's go to our vray multipass manager and open it. Click vray bridge, vray multipass manager. under render elements, special channels, click denoiser. It will show up on the bottom of the hierarchy. Leave all settings as they are, as they seem to work pretty well. You can close this window again. The native Cinema 4D picture view will only show a black image, but the vray frame buffer will open and you will see the image there. And that's it. Now you can enjoy a high quality denoised image or frame sequence in a fraction of the time. If you think this lesson was valuable to you, please like this video and subscribe to my channel. Make sure you hit the bell icon to get notifications every time we publish a new video. Thank you for watching.